To understand why the injections are important, it is useful to know what is happening within the heart with rheumatic heart disease. This shows healthy blood flow through the different chambers of the heart. Blood flowing through healthy valves moves without restriction through the four chambers of the heart. There are four valves: the mitral valve between the left atrium and ventricle, the tricuspid valve between the right atrium and ventricle, the aortic valve, and the pulmonary valve. Each valve is made up of leaflets that separate fully to allow smooth blood flow and then close tightly together to prevent backflow. This ensures that the blood circulates in one direction. In some people, the body's autoimmune response to a group A streptococcal or guest infection causes inflammation. This is ARF and can include inflammation of the heart, which is called carditis. The heart valves may also become inflamed, which causes stretching and thickening of the valve leaflets. When the carditis resolves, some valve leaflets may remain scarred, stiff and immobile, or stretched. This is rheumatic heart disease. The valves predominantly affected in RHD are those on the left side of the heart, the mitral and aortic valves. There are two conditions of the heart valves in RHD, regurgitation and stenosis. With valvular regurgitation, the stretched leaflets have not regained shape and therefore do not close completely. This causes blood to leak backwards. Regurgitation is also referred to as insufficiency or a leaky valve. With valvular stenosis, the stretched leaflets have remained thickened and stiff, and the opening is narrowed, reducing the amount of blood that can flow through. If the narrowing is mild, the overall functioning of the heart may not be reduced. However, in severe stenosis, blood can back up and pool in the chambers, preventing adequate blood flow through the body. Blood pooling in the chambers has a greater tendency to clot, increasing the risk of a stroke or pulmonary embolism. Regurgitation usually happens early in the disease, stenosis later in the disease process. It is possible to have both stenosis and regurgitation in one or more heart valves at the same time. And valves that do not have smooth contours are more likely to become infected. As valve damage progresses, the heart has to work harder to circulate the right amount of blood through the body. In severe cases, the heart muscle enlarges and thickens, thereby losing elasticity and efficiency. It is common for people with RHD to develop heart failure.